Right. We'll start with a new chapter. Heading petna na. Cue the heading. Capital gains. Then after that notes got right.
Yes, sir.
Give the heading capital gains. Capital gains.
Yes, sir. Capital gains.
Yeah. Chapter weightage vachesi 6 marks to 8 marks. Chapter weightage 6 marks to 8 marks. Most important topic, na?
Yes, sir.
Most important topic. Now, why most important? If you remember, see IPCC or CA interlo, salaries, capital gains, business and profession. These are the most three important topics.
Yes.
So mandatory, we expect a question from this chapter. Okay. Section number little, section number 45.
Yes, sir.
To 55 capital A. Section 45 to 55 capital A. Section 45 to 55 capital A.
Yes.
Start chestama?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Chalo. Rai naatho pat raa raase nu kuda introduction.
Okay, sir.
Introduction. Introduction lo see if you remember. కొంచెం ఆలోచిస్తాం హెడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ ఎన్ని ఉన్నాయి కార్తిక్
ఫైవ్ సార్
ఫైవ్ హెడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఏంటి
సాలరీ హౌస్ ప్రాపర్టీ బిజినెస్ అండ్ ప్రొఫెషన్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్ ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ అదర్ సోర్సెస్
ఇన్కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ అంటే ఇది ఇండైరెక్ట్లీ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఫోర్త్ హెడ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ రైట్ నా
ఎస్
ఇది రెగ్యులర్ హెడ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ కాదు దిస్ హెడ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కమ్ విల్ అప్లై ఓన్లీ వెన్ యూఆర్ మేకింగ్ అ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఆఫ్ క్యాపిటల్ అసెట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అంటే లేమన్ వర్షన్ వెన్ ఎవర్ యూఆర్ మేకింగ్ అ సేల్ ఆఫ్ క్యాపిటల్ అసెట్ యూ హావ్ టు కంప్యూట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్ Am I clear? So yes. This is given in which section? Section number 45 says this. Section 45 says what? Simply first section. If you remember, the first section in every chapter is called charging section. If you remember,
yes.
Like in salaries, section number 15 is charging section.
Yes.
In house property, section number 22. In business and profession, section number 28. In capital gain, section number 45. Now 28 in business and profession, 45 in capital gains. And section 56 for IFRS. Matlab the first section of every chapter is nothing but what you know, the charging section.
Charging section.
Yeah, that section will tell you what all incomes can be covered by this chapter. So we'll start that point only. You can write with me. Slowly you can gradually write with me. Point number one. Point number one.
Yes, sir.
Point number one. We compute. We compute capital gains. We compute capital gains on transfer. This is a keyword. We compute capital gains on transfer of capital asset. On transfer of what asset? Capital asset.
Capital asset.
Yeah, this section simply says that whenever there is a transfer of capital asset, you have to compute capital gains, right? No?
Yes, sir.
Right. Point number two. You can write in the flowchart manner. Point number two. Slowly, I'll connect everything. Huh? Point number two. So there should be a capital asset. There should be a capital asset. Oh, great. Then what should happen? There should be a transfer of capital asset. Capital asset undali. There should be a transfer of capital asset.
Transfer.
There has to be a capital asset. There has to be a transfer of capital asset. Then what we do? We compute. We compute capital gains. Simple. Matlab there should be a capital asset. There should be a transfer of capital asset. That is what this section simply says. Right. Going further. Now what we need to understand, sir? What do you mean by capital asset? We also need to understand, sir, what do you mean by transfer of capital asset? You're able to hear me, Karthik?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, keep telling. Huh? Third one is we have to compute capital gains, right? Now, so three things we have to understand. First,
yes, sir, yes.
The meaning of the term called capital asset.
Capital asset.
The meaning of the term called transfer. And third one is how to compute capital gains, right? Now,
capital gains.
Yeah, capital gains, right?
Yes,
so,
sir.
If you observe one by one, the term capital asset is defined where, you know, this is defined in section 2, subsection 14. Section 2, subsection 14 defines the term what? Capital asset. Okay.
Capital asset.
There has to be a transfer of capital asset. Who will define transfer? Section 2, subsection 47. Section 2, subsection 47 of Income Tax Act defines the term called what, you know? Transfer.
Transfer.
Okay, but we have to understand slowly. Each definition we'll understand slowly. Third one is nothing but we have to compute what we have to compute, capital gains. When you say you have to compute
capital gains.
Capital gains are of two types. One is called long-term capital gain. Second is called short-term capital gain.
Short-term capital gain.
Two type of capital gains are there. One is long-term, second is short-term. Now, when does long-term capital gain arise? Long-term capital gain arise when there is a transfer of capital asset held as long-term. Now, what I'm telling very clearly, if you observe, if you're holding an asset for long-term, layman version, 3 years or more, if you're holding any asset for a period of 3 years or more, then that asset is called nothing but what, you know, long-term assets.
Long-term assets.
Yeah. Whenever you make a transfer of long-term assets, then you have to compute what? Long-term capital gain.
Long-term capital gain.
So if an asset is not long-term, it will become what?
Short-term.
Yeah, that's it. Very simple. So when we compute short-term capital gain, we compute short-term capital gain when there is a transfer of capital asset, which is held as short-term. Which is held as what? Short-term.
Short term.
Yeah. Matlab, from here, we got three things to understand. First thing to understand is the meaning of the term called capital asset. This we have to understand. The meaning of the term called what? Capital asset. Ye samajhna padega.
Capital asset.
Yeah, this we have to understand. Then we have to understand the meaning of the term called what? You know, transfer.
Transfer.
Then we have to understand when you compute capital gains, there are two types of capital gains. One is called long term and second is called short term.
Short term.
Manu, what do you mean by term? Matlab, the term itself is something we need to understand. When an asset is said to be long-term, when an asset is said to be what, sir? Short-term.
Short-term.
No, nothing wrong. Imagine if I'm having a building. If I'm having a building which is 10 years old, is it long-term or short-term?
Long-term.
Yeah, matlab, there's some definition has to be there in the background, which will tell you which asset is classified as long-term, which asset is classified as short-term. It's all about term only, if you observe. We are discussing something here called term. Term means period. What we are discussing is nothing but what, you know, term here, term.
Term.
Term matlab, what is the period of holding? Aapne kitne saal asset ko hold kiya hai? For how many years did you hold the asset is called nothing but term. Shall we start?
Yes, sir.
Now, see, I'll ask you one thing. Imagine, Karthik, if I have transferred the asset to you today, yes, but you are paying me money after 2 years. So should I compute capital gain today or for 2 years?
Today.
Yeah, very good. That is also given in section 45. So third point says what, you know, you can write with me. Point number three. As per section 45, as per section 45, we compute capital gains in the previous year in which asset is transferred. In the year in which asset is transferred. Now what I am telling, the year in which you transfer the asset, that year you have to compute the capital gain. Are you able to understand, Karthik?
Yes, sir.
That is in simple terms, we compute capital gains in the year in which transfer is complete. I'm very clear with my terms. If you observe, unless and until the transfer is not completed, we do not compute capital gain. So consideration, secondary question. Whether you have received the money or not, that will become a secondary question. So once you say, sir, transfer is complete, gone the case, you have to compute capital gain.
Capital.
Yeah, right? So,
yes,
so this point number three is all about timing of computation. Timing. Point number three is about timing of computation of capital gain. So what we have learned till now, if you observe, see, weightage of this chapter is 6 to 8 marks.
6 to 8 marks.
And this is the most important topic for exam.
Yes.
Section series is about section number 45 to 55.
45 to 55A.
Super. Introduction we have started. Just now we have started introduction. Now what we do, section 45 simply says we compute capital gain when there is a transfer of capital asset.
Transfer of capital.
Section 45 simply says. No, we started analyzing that point. So there should be a capital asset. There should be a transfer of capital asset. Then we start computing what? Capital gains.
Capital gains.
So what do you mean by capital asset? Government says, check section 2, subsection 14. You will get the meaning of the term called what? You know, capital asset.
Capital.
Likewise, you can check section number 2, subsection 47 to understand the meaning of the term called what? Transfer. So capital gains can be of how many types? Two types. One is called long-term capital gains. Second is called what? Short-term capital gains.
Short-term capital gains.
Long-term and short-term. When you compute long-term, when there is a transfer of asset held as long-term.
Long-term.
Yeah. When you compute short-term capital gain, when the asset is held
transfer
as what?
Asset. Short.
Transfer of asset is short-term. Very simple, right? Now, when to compute capital gain? Okay. We will compute capital gain when there is a transfer. Question is, when to compute capital gain? Government says you compute transfer. Capital gain in the year in which the transfer is complete, not transfer. Transfer. Transfer will ask you to compute capital gain, but when to compute is also important. Now, the timing of taxability. Because here there is no books of accounts. We don't maintain books of accounts and capital gains. So accrual method of accounting, a cash method of accounting, that is not relevant here. Method of accounting is relevant where only in business and profession chapter and IFRS chapter, if you remember.
Yes, sir.
So the government says what? Whenever there is a transfer of capital asset, you please compute capital gain. Am I clear? Now, yes, very, very important point. One important note is coming here. Note. Note. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
There are four exceptions. There are four exceptions to the principle of. There are four exceptions to the principle of timing. Timing for computing capital gains. Now, what is this point? I'll tell you. This is really important. Huh? Slowly we'll connect all the points. Where shall I do? Undo. Undo. One more undo. Yeah. Sir Karthik, what we are discussing? What we are discussing, there are four situations where we don't compute capital gains right now. Though the asset is transferred today, we don't compute capital gains now. We compute capital gains in a future period. So what are those cases? You would remember right now, all these cases are important. Okay, shall we go to the next page?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you can write with me case by case.
Okay.
Case number one. Case number one. Total four cases are there. Okay. Case number one.
Okay, sir.
When capital asset is lost because of fire accident or a natural calamity. When capital asset is lost because of fire accident or natural calamity.
Natural calamity.
Or two reasons I have given till now. One is fire accident. Second is natural calamity. Or you're writing, Karthik?
Yes, sir.
Or because of civil disturbances. So what I'm telling you, it's a very different point if you observe. What does case number one says? See, imagine my building is there. My building is worth 1 crore, 1 crore ka building.
Yes.
I have taken insurance of that building because I'm an educated person. So obviously I have to take insurance of that building. So maybe what happened due to some natural calamities, the complete building got fall because of earthquake. No doubt. No, there is no loss of life. To my good luck, we were outstation. The complete building got collapsed because of natural calamities. Will I get insurance claim or not?
Yes, sir.
But prior to time, will I get the insurance claim in the same day?
No, sir.
No. So government says, do one thing. See, in this case, no doubt you will get insurance claim. But please compute capital gain whenever you get the insurance claim. No doubt the asset got destroyed. No doubt the asset got transferred. Transfer is complete. But we are not asking you to compute capital gain now. We'll ask you to compute when you know compute capital gains. We should compute capital gains only in the previous year in which insurance claim is received. Yeah, very good. In the year in which insurance claim is received.
Yes.
The year in which you got insurance claim, that year you compute capital gain. That would be sufficient.
Yes, sir.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So what is case number one? You have to remember slowly. And these are important cases. See, anything which is exception to the general point will become nothing but important point only. What is the general point? Transfer ho gaya, please compute capital gain. This point says, no. No doubt, the transfer is complete, but we are asking not to compute capital gain. No, when will compute capital gain? When you receive the insurance claim. I mean, clear? So what is most important here? When did you receive the insurance claim? That is most important point. So whenever you receive the insurance claim, then you should compute capital gain. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, case number two. Please write neatly, both lengthy chapter. Case number two. When capital asset is converted into stock in trade. When capital asset is converted into stock in trade.
Stock in trade.
This is a very different point if you observe. Imagine at my family, there are around 20 ladies. We are a joint family. Example, we are around a joint family. We got 20-25 ladies at home. So collectively, we found that they are having around 5 kgs of gold. Which is a capital asset?
Yes, sir.
I got an idea. Let me start a jewelry business with this. Now, what is happening if you observe? We are simply converting the capital asset into what, you know, stock in trade. Now, see how intelligently I'm behaving. I'm not selling the stock in trade. No, I'm not doing anything right now. I'm simply converting the capital asset into what? Stock in trade.
Stock in trade.
Nothing. I'm not doing anything. See, of conversion karom. Now, tell me one thing. Yes. Just by doing conversion, is there a transfer?
No.
So remember one thing government says, dance is now. If you are converting capital asset into stock in trade, we say it's a transfer. Transfer ho gaya. But we logically know there is no transfer. Because just by conversion, there is no sale. Try to understand. Just by conversion, the activity of sale did not happen. Maybe the asset is no more a capital asset. That's it. The government says, do one thing. You compute capital gain. Can I write the answer now?
Yes, sir.
We compute capital gains in the previous year in which stock in trade is sold. Did you observe the difference answer here? So when we compute capital gain, we compute capital gain in the year in which the stock in trade is sold. Because upon conversion, logically there is no sale. So government says, okay, we'll wait for the real sale. When the real sale will happen? When you sell the stock in trade.
Yes.
So if you observe carefully, when a capital asset is converted into stock in trade, the transfer is there. But we don't compute capital gain now. When we compute capital gain, when the stock in trade is sold. Yeah, what we are learning, if you remember, we are learning exceptions. What we are learning is exceptions to timing computation. The first case is insurance case.
Yes, sir.
Second case is a conversion case.
Capital to stock in trade.
Yeah, conversion case, right? Can I go to the third case?
Yes, sir.
Case number three. Case number three is nothing but when capital asset is acquired by way of not acquired. You can write a wrong word, not acquired. You should write transferred. when the capital asset is transferred by way of compulsory acquisition. When the capital asset is transferred by way of what, you know, compulsory acquisition.
Compulsory acquisition.
Now, what is compulsory acquisition? If you remember, see, most of the time the government takes land and building by way of compulsory acquisition for public welfare.
Yes.
Like metro. See, most of the metros are running through roads, but there are some areas where a road was not taken, houses were taken, land were taken from the public for what? For compulsory acquisition, so that they can run a metro there.
Yes.
Not right, Nishan. If my land or if my building, anything it can be, it can be any asset for the time. If my land or if my building is given to the government because of compulsory acquisition, do you really feel they'll pay the compensation immediately?
They'll take years.
Oh, they may take. Oh, very good. See, though you're having little knowledge, you're telling, sir, samachral padtam time. The government says, do one thing. Whenever you get the compensation, then you compute capital gain. If you get compensation 5 years late, compute capital gains 5 years later. Am I clear?
Yes.
Very logical point. So what we do? We compute capital gains in the previous year, in which we compute capital gains in the previous year, in which
compensation is
initial paid. Compensation is received. We compute capital gains in the previous year in which initial compensation is received. Another simple bhasha, eppudaithe double vaste appudu cheyiskondi. Suppose if the building is taken in the year 2020, building is taken in the year 2020, but the compensation is given in the year 2025, then when we compute capital gain, we compute capital gain in the year 2025 only.
Yes.
Shall we?
Yes, sir.
I said a total 4 case, na? Last case. Case number? 4. Tell them, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Case number 4. Case number 4 is what, you know? When land or building or both. When land or building or both are given under joint development agreement. When land or building or both are given under joint development agreement. Joint development agreement. I'll tell you what is this. This is called JDA. You know these terms? What is joint development agreement?
No, sir.
Imagine, simple case. I got 2 acres of land at Miyapur. Maybe my grandfather or my father has taken 2 acres land very cheaply at that time. But today land is very costly, na? See, I have land, but I don't have resource to construct the building on it. And land undi ante, land undi. Kan double levu construction ki skill set ledu. I don't have proper skill set to develop the property my way own. Now you are a developer. You approach me. What you said, you know? Sir, you give the land to me. We will develop the property on it. We will develop 500 flats on it. 500 flats.
Yes, sir.
50% flat you keep, 50% flat we will keep.
Yes.
This is what you are telling me. Land belongs to me. Building belongs to you. But jointly we are developing.
Yes, sir.
Construction cost, you will take care. That's not my headache. Because I have given land to you. The consideration, what you will give me? Constructed flats.
50%.
50%. In my example, you will give me 50% constructed flats. But yes, can you give me consideration right now?
No, sir.
No, it will take some time. Na? The government says what, you know? Wait for the completion of those flats.
Yes.
Nothing wrong. See, Karthik, if I'm giving you land right now, I expect consideration. But problem is, you cannot give me consideration right now. What you'll say? Sir, building kattadan koncham time padtundi. Give me some 2-3 years time. So what we'll do, you'll do development of that property and then the developed property will transfer me back.
Yes.
Ni doubt in ante. Sir, naake migultundi annitlo. See, 50% flats you're giving to me. Balance 50% flats you can sell by yourself.
Yes, sir.
So in this case, when we compute capital gain, generally we compute capital gains. Generally, we compute capital gains in the previous year in which completed properties received as consideration.
Yes, sir.
We compute capital gains in the previous year in which completed properties received as what, you know, consideration. So it may take 3 years time, it may take 4 years time, it may take 10 years time also. So government says when you are giving land and you are getting consideration in the form of constructed flats, so no need to compute capital gains now. Wait for the completed property, then you can do construction. Sorry, then you can do computation of capital gains.
Yes,
so four cases clear?
Yes, sir.
First case is what case you tell me?
Insurance claims.
Yeah, very good. This is called insurance claim case.
Yes.
Second case is what you tell me?
Conversion of capital asset to stock in trade.
Very good. Conversion case. Third one is what?
Transfer by way of compulsory acquisition.
Compulsory acquisition case. Fourth case is what? Joint development
agreement. Joint development.
Joint development agreement. JDA. Yes, Karthik.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So these are four cases where we don't compute capital gains on the date of transfer. So these are all date of transfer only. Capital asset lost, conversion happening, or a compulsory acquisition happening, or joint development agreement ke niche you have given the land. All these are transfer dates, but we don't compute capital gain now. When we compute capital gain, whenever you receive the consideration, layman version.
Yes.
So whenever you receive the insurance claim, whenever the stock in trade is sold, whenever you get initial compensation, and whenever you get the consideration by way of completed properties. Simple?
Yes, sir.
So, see, everything should be discussed in some section. Question is, what are the relevant section numbers? See, this one is, the first case is section 45, subsection 1A. Section 45, subsection 1A. Insurance claim case. Shall I?
Yes, sir.
Second case is section 45, subsection 2, conversion case. Section 45, yes, subsection 2. You're getting, yes, it, Karthik?
Yes, sir.
Compulsory acquisition case, section 45, subsection 5. Section 45, subsection 5.
Subsection 5.
Yeah, superb. And joint development agreement, section 45, subsection 5A.
Okay.
Remember all the sections numbers, huh? Slowly I'll use somewhere.
Yes, sir.
So what I'm discussing in the second page, what we are discussing is timing exception cases. In these four cases, we compute capital gain not immediately, but we compute capital gain in the future period. The future period is called nothing but what period? Whenever you get the consideration, layman version.
Yes.
So remember these four cases. Leaving these four cases, in any other case, we compute capital gain in the year in which the transfer is complete. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Transfer is complete. Shall we write that as a note?
Yes, sir.
Note. Leaving above four cases. Fine, four cases, let's say. We compute capital gains in the previous year. We compute capital gains in the previous year in which transfer takes place. The year in which the transfer is complete, we start computing capital gains. Very simple.
Yes.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Eldama?
Yes, sir.
So this is a basic introduction. Introduction may, we are yet to see so many things. What we are supposed to see now, the meaning of the term called capital asset, the meaning of the term called transfer.
Transfer.
What do you mean by long term? What do you mean by short term?
short
term. How to compute capital gains, how to compute long-term capital gains, how to compute short-term capital gains. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Shall we start now?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, give the next heading. Give the next heading. Capital asset. Section 2, subsection 14. Karthik, you tell me what do you mean by capital asset? As per you, what do you mean by capital asset?
Anything which is a part of business,
mm-hmm.
and it gives us long-term income.
Okay, so you are telling the definition of fixed asset basically. I'll ask you one thing. Jewelry at my home, is it not a capital asset?
Yes, sir, capital asset.
But you are telling only business assets are capital assets, na? So very important point to understand is, don't go into balance sheet concept. Matlab, no doubt, business assets are capital assets, but it can be personal assets also, na? Me intlo koni lands undochu kada, me mother, me father, your grandfather may have some lands. They are not business assets, but still are they asset or not? Me intlo oka car undochu, car. Car undochu kada, nothing wrong kada. That is an asset or not? Yes, it's an asset. So what government says, you see, the definition is very simple. How the government has given the definition of the term called capital asset. Shall I start?
Yes, sir.
First point, you can write with me. Every asset is a capital asset. Very different word, huh? Government says every asset is a capital asset. When I say every asset, I never said every business asset is a capital asset. I simply said every asset is a capital asset. So when I say every asset is a capital asset, what does that mean? That asset may be, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That asset may be movable or immovable. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
That asset may be tangible or it may be what? Intangible. The asset may be a business asset or it may be a personal asset.
Yes, sir.
Layman version. What government says? Government says every asset is a capital asset. It may be a tangible asset. It may be an intangible asset. It may be movable asset. It may be immovable asset. It may be held in the course of business. It may be a personal asset. Does not really matter. See, government perspective is very clear. Let's cover everything. Let's not define capital asset narrowly. Every asset is a capital asset. Layman version.
Yes.
See, the most important point, difficulty sometimes comes where, when it comes to intangible assets. Intangible assets is, why it is different, I'll tell you. Intangible assets are those assets. Problem is, intangible assets mein, you don't feel the form, na? Right of a person is also called intangible asset. Software ka right hai, holding right hai, license, trademarks, patents, copyrights, goodwill. These are also taken as what, capital assets. Okay. So what is important now? Not to understand what is the meaning of the term capital asset. What they have done, in the second point they said, the following assets are not capital assets. Oh, this is very different. What they're telling? First, these assets are not capital assets. Wow, and indirectly, exception to the chapter. Because what does the chapter say? Chapter says, we compute capital gain in the year in which the transfer takes place. Yes. But when you compute capital gain, when there is a transfer of capital asset,
capital asset.
They're telling, these are not capital assets. There is no need to compute any capital gain.
Capital
gains. And indirectly, any point apply got led. There should be a capital asset, because general point is there.
Yes.
Not required. These are not even taken as capital asset. So you have to learn it very carefully. Point number A. You're able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Point number A. The following are not capital asset. The government says, first one is stock in trade. Now, what do you mean by stock in trade? Anything which is held for sale in the ordinary course of business.
Yes.
Imagine my business is to sell jewelry. Jewelry is what for me?
Stock in trade.
Okay, my business is to sell land and building. Land and building is what for me?
Stock in trade.
Anything which is held for sale in the ordinary course of business is called stock in trade.
Yes,
am I clear? So this is point number A. Point number B. If you want right here, you can write in the first point. Any asset which is held for sale in ordinary course of business.
Yes.
Any asset which is held for sale in the ordinary course of business is called nothing but what, you know, stock in trade. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Shall I ask you a doubt here itself if you don't get confused?
Yes.
The doubt is what, you know, this point is a doubt. Second case. What government says here, if you observe the second case, what government says here, if you observe, government says when you are converting a capital asset in stock in trade, then they will compute capital gain when the stock in trade is sold.
Sold.
But here government says stock in trade is not a capital asset again.
Yes, sir.
Now my doubt is what, you know, careful listen. Logically, we'll do two computation of income. One, this case and this case. Don't get confused. I'm talking about this second case. One.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Upon conversion, there will be a capital gain.
Yes. Transfer.
Upon sale of stock in trade, we have to compute business income.
Okay, sir.
Logically, we'll do two computation in this case. First computation would be capital gain case. Second computation would be business income computation.
Business and profession.
Business and profession computation. Both will do.
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, okay. Slow by slow, you understand. So, stock in trade is not a capital asset. Okay, clear. Point number two. Shall we move?
Yes, sir.
A rural agriculture land is also not a capital asset. This you have seen in the basics class.
Yes, sir.
A rural agriculture land is never taken as capital asset, if you remember. Remember?
10-1.
No. 10-1 is agriculture income, not this. Land. Introduction class. Land.
Yes, sir.
If you remember, if a land is situated in a municipality where the population of the municipality is 10,000 or more, Gurtustunda?
Yes, sir.
That land is an urban agriculture land.
Yes, sir.
If it is outside municipality, within 2 kilometers, within 6 kilometers, within 8 kilometers, Gurtustunda?
Yes, sir.
Only points. So government says, if you are making a transfer of rural agriculture land, there is no need to compute capital gain. Am I clear?
Yes,
point number three, C, personal effects. Very differently they have defined. Government says, whatever personal assets you are holding, personal assets, like example, you are having a laptop with you.
Yes, sir.
That is your personal asset. No need to compute capital gain. Laptop, mobile you are having?
Yes.
No need to compute capital gain. Do you have dining table at your home? No need to compute capital gain. Do you have a car?
Yes, sir.
No need to compute capital gain because all these are your personal effects. Government says if an asset is SSE is personal, then no need to compute capital gain. But problem is what, you know, to this point, they have written exceptions. Exceptions. What are the exceptions, you know? Karthik, adhavutunna?
Yes, sir.
Aim atlarthunna? See, what we are learning is, what is not a capital asset?
Capital asset.
What is not a capital asset? Stock in trade is not a capital asset.
Stock in trade.
Agriculture land is not
rural
a capital
agriculture
asset.
Land.
Personal effects are not capital assets. To this exception, again, we are learning exception. So indirectly, this will become inclusion.
Capital asset.
Very good. This will become capital asset. Personal effects. First one is jewelry. Jewelry, archaeological collections, drawings, paintings, sculptures, and any work of art. Slowly I'll write, no issues. I'll write one by one. Total 6 points are there. First one is what?
Jewelry.
Man intlo gold undu kada, gold.
Yes, sir.
If you make a transfer of that gold, you have to compute capital gain. You cannot say, hey, this is daily wearing gold now. Government says, no, we are not bothered. Even if you wear daily, even if you wear recreationally, if you make a transfer of jewelry, you have to compute capital gains.
Capital gains.
Yes. Jewelry. Second is archaeological collections.
Archaeological
means historical items. Next, drawings. Next, paintings.
Paintings.
Next, sculptures. Last one is any work of art. Sculptures, any work of art.
Yes, sir.
See, Karthik, if you remember, same things we have learned where, you know, in section 56, subsection 2, clause 10, gift to section. Jewelry, archaeological collections, drawings, paintings, sculptures, any work of art, bullion, jewelry, shares and securities. Yes. Those 8 items, if you are transferring, you have to compute gift.
Yes, sir.
Almost the list is similar. What is not covered here, you know, shares and securities.
Shares and securities.
Shares and securities and bullions is not covered here.
Yes.
That's akkad chadindi ikkada chadindi rendu same if you observe.
Yes, sir.
So logically, if you are making transfer of these things, you have to compute capital gains. Do you agree?
Capital gains. Yes, sir.
So I'm writing a note here itself. Transfer of these things will attract
capital gains.
Yeah, will attract capital gains tax. Transfer of these things will attract capital gains tax. It will surely attract. You are getting it?
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. So, total 4 exceptions are there. We have covered 3. First one is what, you know, stock in trade.
Stock in trade.
Stock in trade, if you are making a transfer, no need to compute capital gains.
Capital gains.
Likewise, rural agriculture land, if you are making a transfer, no need to compute capital gains.
Yes, sir.
If you are making a transfer of any asset which is held as a personal effect, no need to compute capital gains. To this personal effect, exceptions are what? Jewelry, archaeological collection, drawings,
paintings,
sculptures.
Any work of art.
Any work of art. If these things, if you are transferring, you have to compute capital gain.
Yes.
Give an example. My mummy is not in club. Example. She's having some gold bangles. Okay, 60 gram gold bangles. Example.
Yes.
She has sold these bangles because of some COVID reason. COVID. Example here. Government says, reason we don't ask, you have to compute capital gain. I said, sir, bangles are being worn daily now. Government says, we don't bother. Are they made of gold? I said, yes, they are made of gold. Then government says, you have to compute capital gains.
Capital gains.
Adamotuda.
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. Point number four is certificates. Certificate issued under gold money, gold monetization scheme. This is very different. I have to explain. Certificates issued under gold monetization scheme. Wow, a complete different point if you observe. Certificates issued under gold monetization scheme. Shall I explain this point?
Yes, sir.
Aramse. Cool ga vinte artham avutundi. Hari bari yodu. Now, what do you mean by gold monetization scheme? Let me understand that. Vinali okkasari vinali. మా ఇంట్లో ఒక 500 గ్రామ్స్ గోల్డ్ ఉంది నాను ఎగ్జాంపుల్ అట్ మై హోమ్ దెర్ ఆర్ సమ్ 500 గ్రామ్స్ ఆఫ్ గోల్డ్ విచ్ ఇస్ వెరీ వెరీ ఓల్డ్ జ్యువెలరీ అంటే వెరీ అవుట్డేటెడ్ నాన్ ట్రెడిషనల్ జ్యువెలరీ నో వన్ ఇస్ రెడీ టు వేర్ కార్తీక్
వింటున్నావు
గవర్నమెంట్ ఏం చెప్పిందంటే ఆ జ్యువెలరీ ఎలా కూడా మీరు వాడట్లేదు కదా ఎనీ హౌ యు ఆర్ నాట్ యూజింగ్ దట్ జ్యువెలరీ వై డోంట్ యూ బ్రింగ్ దట్ జ్యువెలరీ టు అ బ్యాంక్ under this scheme called gold monetization scheme. What they will do with the jewelry? Bank em chestund the jewelry tho bank dani karga pettestundi they will make it in what you called raw form of liquid. Gold and liquid chesesi they will make a raw form of gold stones em unnante they will remove the stones impurities em unnante they will remove impurities physical gold pure form 100 carat 100 touch they will make a measurement imagine it is coming 100 grams the purest form of gold in the jewelry is only 100 grams. The banker will give me a certificate saying that you have deposited with us 100 grams of gold. That certificate is called nothing but certificate issued under gold monetization scheme. Now, question is, what will happen? Government says, see, generally, if you sell gold, there is a need to compute capital gain.
Capital gain.
But if you are making a transfer of gold under gold monetization scheme, you will get a certificate.
Yes, sir.
That certificate, if you make a transfer, there is no need to compute capital gain.
Okay.
So indirectly, if I want to sell gold, I should not sell gold. I should give it under gold monetization scheme.
Monetization scheme.
Then I will get a certificate. The certificate I should sell.
Yes, sir.
Now, try to understand. Oh, no problem is, if I don't want to sell certificate, what will happen? Government says, no problem. You keep the certificate for 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. After 10 years, if you want 100 grams gold, give the certificate, take 100 grams gold with us. Matlab, imagine today gold rate is 50,000 for 10 grams. Karthik, today gold rate is 50,000 for 10 grams. After 10 years, the same gold become 5 lakhs. The certificate value is 5 lakh rupees now.
Okay.
Indirectly, gold certificate is equal to gold only. But it is in purest form of gold.
Yes.
Second benefit, I'll tell you the second benefit. If you hold the certificate, now you will get interest, that too in gold terms. What do you mean by gold terms? I'll tell you. Imagine I got 100 gram certificate.
Yes.
And the rate of interest is 2% per annum.
2 grams gold.
Next year it will become 1 or 2 grams. Hello.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Yes, yeah. Sir. Indirectly, if you keep the same gold in locker, will the value appreciate?
No, sir.
No. Mother, with the same gold, if you keep under gold monetization scheme, slowly the gold value to badega hi badega. Grams bhi badega. Grams
also will increase.
Super, yes, na? So government, yes, says, if you deposit your gold with a bank, no doubt your gold will not be given back. You'll be getting only a certificate. And tomorrow, if you want gold, they'll not give you jewelry. They'll give you gold only, purest form of gold.
Yes, sir.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So certificates issued under gold monetization scheme. So these are the four exceptions to the term called capital asset. What is the first exception? Stock in trade.
Stock in trade, yes, sir.
Second exception, rural agriculture land. Third exception, personal effects. Fourth exception is nothing but certificate issued under gold monetization scheme. Very easy, na?
Yes,
so, one small note we'll write. Note. On transfer of above assets A, B, C, D. On transfer of above assets, that is A, B, C, D, there would be no capital gain.
Capital gains.
Yes. There will be no capital gains. There is no need to compute any capital gain.
Capital gains.
Hey, hello, this point again will not apply to these things, huh? Which things?
Exceptions.
Yeah. There is jewelry.
Jewelry.
Archaeological collections, drawings, paintings, sculptures, any artwork. Any artwork, very good. Any work of art or any artwork. If you are transferring these things, you have to compute capital gains.
Yes, sir.
Super. So one is called stock in trade. Second is called rural agriculture land. Third is called personal effects. Fourth one is called nothing but what?
Gold monetization.
Certificate issued under gold monetization scheme.
Yes.
Confuse odu. Gold schemes rendu unnai India lo. One is, if you want to buy gold for gold investment, bonds. People purchase RBI bonds.
Yes.
These are called gold deposit bonds. Gold deposit bonds are not covered here. What is covered here? The deposit of gold with the bank, physical gold deposit, surely.
Yes.
If you deposit physical gold with the bank, then what you get is gold monetization scheme kind of a certificate. That certificate is not a capital asset.
Okay.
And the Okade scheme covered is here. Two schemes, only one scheme they have covered.
Yes, sir.
Clear, huh? So what we have understood is these things we have understood. The meaning of the term called capital asset. Every asset is a capital asset except stock in trade, rural agriculture land,
personal effects,
certificate under gold monetization scheme. I'll do one thing. I'll show you one small point to you. Gold monetization scheme. Go. Images. 1 minute. Huh? Yeah, you can just casually see this. Slow eyesight. We'll just see. Just have a look. You're getting the image now?
No, sir. Now I'm getting, sir.
Yeah, just casually just have a look.
Yes, sir.
So what is happening with this? See, a lot of import of gold we can save. Those golds which are kept in lockers can now come to bank. Now bank can utilize this by selling this gold to jewelers. Jewelers can save import duty. India can save foreign currency. So there are a lot of benefits. You may feel it's a very small scheme, but the benefit will come to jewelers. The benefit will come to bankers. The benefit will come to customers. Government of India can save foreign currency. It's like win-win situation for everyone.
Yes, sir.
Getting?
Sir, they cannot deposit more than 30 grams.
No, minimum is 30 grams.
Minimum 30 grams.
Minimum is 30 grams. You cannot say 1 gram I want a certificate. They'll not give you. Minimum 30 gram rupees. 30 grams. Shall we move?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Chalo, next point I'm taking. Next heading. Let us understand the meaning of the term called transfer. Next heading. Transfer section 2, subsection 47. Transfer may not be that important for exam, but still. Transfer. Now, why this is important? Why important? Because we compute capital gain only when there's a transfer of capital asset.
Transfer of capital asset.
See, unless there is no transfer, you don't compute capital gain.
Yes, sir.
So, government kya bolti hai? Government says, transfer includes. See, they are defined very differently. They simply say transfer includes. They never say transfer means. The definition given is an inclusive definition. Shall we write? Layman question, what do you mean by transfer? Yeah? Sale, yeah.
Yes, sir.
The term transfer includes sale. It also includes exchange. Or barter. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
The term transfer includes sale. And when there is a need to compute capital gain, when there is a transfer of capital asset, what do you mean by transfer? Government says 99% transfer means sale only. Or it can be exchange also. It can be barter also.
Barter system.
Barter and exchange of assets.
Good to good.
Yeah, good to good. Or maybe something.
Good to service.
Yes, yeah, good to service. That's called barter. Next. Relinquishment. I'll explain this. See, what do you mean by relinquishment? Leaving the right over the asset. Imagine I got some land at Miyapur, some temple trust. They came to me and they said, sir, gudi kavali maku, sorry, land kavali gudi kattistanu. Nen cheppesan starting, hey, one rupee bani. Example.
Yes, sir.
Then I felt, okay, let's give some 200 yards for a temple. What's wrong? Government says, you are making a transfer. I said, no, sir, I'm not making a transfer. Government says, yes, there is a transfer. Whether to compute capital gain or not is a secondary question. But whenever you're leaving a right over the asset, even that is also taken as transfer.
Transfer.
So sale, exchange, barter, relinquishment. Next. Extinguishment. extinguishment of rights. Now, what in my extinguishment of right, you know? Imagine I got a car. Need not be a personal car, huh? Because personal car I cannot use anymore. Because personal car is a personal effect, na?
Personal effect, not.
So I am talking about a business car. I got a business car. Some civil disturbances, may I lost the car. Matam fire accident lo, maybe some petrol little possessi matam taral bete sir car ni. Now government says this is a transfer. I said war. To whom I have transferred? To no one. Government says, because when you claim insurance amount from the insurance company, if you observe, when you claim insurance amount from the insurance company, you are leaving a right over the asset or not?
Yes, sir.
Your right got extinguished or not?
Yes.
Thereby, even this is taken as what you know, extinguishment of right.
Transfer.
Yeah, this is also taken as transfer. Now, one example of extinguishment of right is, you know, conversion of debentures into equity shares. See, you're a debenture holder. If your debentures got converted into equity, you are no more a debenture holder, na?
Yes, sir.
This is called extinguishment of right. Your right of debenture holder is gone.
Yes, sir.
Getting?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Extinguishment of right. Next, point number E. See, knowledge person chupnana na exam lo evadu adagadu. Knowledge ke liye padara. Next, sale, exchange, relinquishment, extinguishment. Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Next, compulsory acquisition. See, even if your asset is taken under compulsory acquisition, even that is taken as what you know, transfer.
Transfer.
Generally, compulsory acquisition lo consent undal kada, consent. Still, government says consent unna lekapoyina transfer ayipoyinatte. Next, conversion of capital asset into stock in trade. Conversion of capital asset into stock in trade.
Stock in trade.
Adavutunda?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Indirectly by converting a capital asset into stock in trade, logically there is no sale. So government says conversion happened, kada? It is taken as transfer. We are not asking you to compute capital gains. No. When we'll ask you to compute capital gain, we'll ask you to compute capital gain when stock in trade is sold.
Business and profession.
Gurtunda?
Yes, sir.
Whenever there is a conversion, we are not asking you to compute capital gain. No. We are asking you to compute capital gain when the stock in trade is sold.
Stock in trade is sold.
Gurtochinda?
Yes, sir.
Right. Point number H. Redemption of zero coupons bonds. Redemption of zero coupon bonds, ZCB. Chetan, zero coupon bonds are ten dollars, huh? You invest the money today, the money will come back only after 5-7 years. And the majula interest raga, they don't pay any interest. Imagine 10,000 rupees bond. Karthik, went to nama?
Yes, sir. Went na, sir.
10,000 rupees bond, they'll issue at 5,500.
Okay.
And man, ganbisundi, 10,000 bond, 5,500. Government is very clear. Babu, 10,000 bond, but I'm giving you at 5,500. You have to wait for 7 years to get 10,000 back. So indirectly, man feeling enti, man tirigostundi. Government says no. Today you are investing 5,500. After 7 years, you are getting 10,000. Na? At that point of time, you have to complete capital gains. Why you have to complete capital gains? Why? Because all these years you did not offer interest.
Yes.
Interest you which led, na? Anyone logically zero coupon. What am I zero coupon? They're not paying any interest.
No interest.
No interest. So this is the case of what you know transfer. Transfer meaning chudandi. One is called sale.
Exchange.
Chappala adhamo thunda.
Yes sir. Yes sir. Sale.
Sale. Next,
yes,
exchange. Next, market. Relinquishment.
Yes,
extinguishment. Compulsory acquisition. Conversion of capital asset into stock in trade.
Stock in trade.
And last one is redemption of?
Redemption of zero coupon bonds.
So all these cases are taken as nothing but what you know. All these transfer. Cases are taken as transfer cases.
Transfer. Yes, sir.
Elta mundu keltama?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, these are all transfers. Got chinna note right na, we'll discuss separately. Note. note. Very important note for exam, but I'm not discussing now. నీకు గుర్తుంటే రివర్స్ మార్టిగేజ్ చెప్పాను గుర్తుందా?
Yes sir.
రివర్స్ మార్టిగేజ్ మీన్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ట్రాన్స్‌ఫరింగ్ ది అసెట్ ఇస్ ఇట్ టేకెన్ యాస్ ట్రాన్స్‌ఫర్ ఆర్ నాట్ టేకెన్ యాస్ ట్రాన్స్‌ఫర్?
నాట్ టేకెన్ యాస్ ట్రాన్స్‌ఫర్.
ఆ ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఆ పాయింట్ నోట్ నోట్ సెక్షన్ నంబర్ 47 కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవుతు. హావ్ ఎ లుక్ సెక్షన్ 247 డిఫైన్స్ ద టర్మ్ ట్రాన్‌ఫర్ బట్ వేర్ యాస్
yes,
సెక్షన్ 47 డిఫరెంట్ ఏ Section 47 provides list of those cases. Section 47 provides list of those cases where transfer is not treated as transfer. Abhi idhu variety ga undi. Transfer undi. But we will not treat as transfer. And indirectly, whatever is covered in section 47, there is no need to compute capital gains. Chudandi, confuse avadu. Section 47 provides a list of those cases where transfer is not treated as what you know, transfer.
Transfer
ni transfer lag chudanu. Shall we start those cases?
Yes, sir.
Simple. See what we are learning. Section 247 defines the term called transfer. Adi important kadu. What becomes important? Cases where transfer unna transfer ni transfer laga bhavinchali. So we'll start with those cases. Shall we start?
Okay.
Right. We'll start with those cases. Heading right na. Section number 47. Cases where transfer does not attract
capital.
Yeah, very good, Nana. Does not attract capital gains tax. Cases where transfer does not attract capital gains tax. Logical chapalante transfer undi. Logically there is a transfer, but government believes. Chalo chodana, no need to compute capital gains. Koni important points unnai, we'll see one by one. Shall we start?
Yes, sir.
Case number one. Idantha introduction nadustundi inka. Kani important.
Okay.
Case number one. Where a company is in liquidation. Where a company is in liquidation. Sir, heading enti cheptanu heading ide. Where the company is in liquidation. Main point enti liquidation point. See, I'll tell you one thing. Heading idi. What is the point? A company, you can write with me. Yes. A company in liquidation. A company in liquidation. Will make a transfer of capital asset in kind. This word is very, very important. When they make a transfer of a capital asset in kind, to whom? To its shareholders. When a company is in liquidation and it transfer capital asset in kind to its shareholders, company ever the owners they gada?
Owners.
So government says, company, you don't compute capital gain. You know who will compute capital gain? Shareholders will compute.
Shareholders.
Why? Shareholders are losing right of shareholding in the company.
Hmm.
Very logical. Idhar endu compute cheyali. Ippudu company nenu unna shareholder. Whatever assets are belonging to me, I have given to you. What you are losing in the company, you are losing shareholding right.
Right.
Yes. The government says,
extinguishment.
I will not, very good, extinguishment. I will not compute capital gain. You will compute capital gain. But all this drama will apply when the company is in liquidation.
Company is in liquidation.
And that two assets are given in kind to each shareholders.
Kind.
Chudu. Situation one. Company is not in liquidation. This point will not apply. Company is not giving assets to its shareholders. Given to someone outsiders. This point will not apply. Company is not giving asset as such in kind. It's giving money. Then also this point will not apply. E point apply only three situations. It should be a company. It should be in liquidation. It should give distribution of assets in kind to its shareholders.
In kind. Yes, sir.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, case number two. Atmatumnaga.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good. Case number two. When HUF transfer assets to its members at the time of partition. Oh wow, different case. What we are discussing? The assets are given at the time of what, you know, partition.
Partition.
Partition outunga HUF gurtunda. Hindu undivided family law. If one or more co-partners they want to come out from the HUF, that's called nothing but partition.
Partition.
Gurtu sunna.
Yes, sir.
So ikkada rasna jo. Hindu undivided family is making a transfer of capital asset, the two in kind, to whom? To its members.
Members.
At the time of what, you know? In kind. At the time of, very important case. At the time of partition of HUF.
Yes.
If Hindu undivided family makes a transfer of capital asset in kind, very important case, when they are making transfer at the time of partition of HUF, then government says such a transfer is not taken as transfer. Don't forget, even members will not complete any capital gain. And the government ki a logical analogy is the HUF over the members there. So HUF nunchi asset members ko chindi. Tomorrow member will transfer the asset, na, then we'll catch the capital gains tax. We'll amend and go bite kelli. If member is making a transfer to an outsider, then we'll ask him to pay capital gains tax.
Yes, sir.
Elda ma?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, very easy cases now. Case number three. Case number three. When holding company, transfers capital asset to its 100% subsidiary. Oh, main important point in ikkada. The subsidiary should be a 100% subsidiary. If you observe, 100% subsidiary ante complete shareholding ever daggara undi holding company daggara.
Holding company.
Is it ikkadunna akkadunna? What is the difference? It does not make a difference because the company belongs to holding company.
Yes.
So if holding company is giving the asset to its 100% subsidiary, holding company will not compute capital gain. Kan jagratha. The subsidiary company should be an Indian company.
Okay, sir.
The subsidiary company should be an Indian company. Lathe, Indian ledanko, asset kuda velipothayi and ultimately government will lose tax in this.
Lose tax, yes, sir.
Endukante, if the subsidiary company is a foreign company, now government cannot catch the foreign company. Anduke. Case number four. Can I move?
Yes, sir.
When 100% subsidiary, when 100% subsidiary transfers capital asset to whom?
Holding.
Very good. To its holding company. Same as the relation.
Yes, sir.
But government says again one thing. The holding Indian company should be what company? Indian company.
Indian company.
Ah, very important. Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Four cases in Inkeltana. Case number five. Case number five. When transfer is because of amalgamation. When transfer is because of what, you know, amalgamation.
Amalgamation.
Now, what is this point? See, amalgamation, who will transfer the asset to whom?
Company.
Which company?
Old company to new company.
Ah, very good. That's called amalgamating company. Will make a transfer of asset to amalgamated company. So, amalgamating company. Amalgamating company will make a transfer of capital asset to which company? Amalgamated company.
Amalgamated company.
Ante kada? Now common sense case, this amalgamated company should be what company?
Indian company.
Indian company. And the transfer of asset should be because of what?
Amalgamation.
This should be because of amalgamation. See, one of the core conditions of amalgamation is what, you know, all the assets and all the liabilities should be transferred to amalgamated company. One of the principal conditions. Yes, if you remember, case number 6. Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Shall I move? When?
Yes.
When the transfer is without consideration. Very important point. When the transfer is without consideration. Without ante, can we simply say free?
Yes.
I have given 200 acres of 200 yards of land to a temple trust.
Temple trust.
And actually the transfer ante, yes, it's a transfer. Why? Because you are relinquishing the right. But God grace, I am not computing capital gain. Why? Because it's covered by case number 6. Oho, transfer unda ante undi. But logically, I am not computing capital gain. Why? Because section 47 says, whatever you transfer without even consideration, transfer, there is no need to compute capital gain. Shall we write?
Okay, yes, sir.
In simple terms, if any capital asset is transferred without consideration. See, I'm not telling inadequate consideration here. I'm telling without.
Without consideration.
Is transferred without consideration. Without consideration, then there is no need to compute capital gain.
Capital gains.
But there is one problem if you observe here. The problem is, transferor will not compute capital gain. But in the hands of transferee, gift to provision may attract. Jagrata. Ippudu nenu land ni ichesanu anku punyanki. Example. Naaku em undadu bharam. Kannu unna naaku relative kaadu kada. You are not my relative. Thereby government will ask Karthik to pay tax by computing gift income. Nato be careful. Note and rasa stampane potundi. Note. However, in the hands of recipient, gift section may attract. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
I'm not telling it shall attract. It may attract.
Yes, sir.
So you can refer section 56, subsection 2, clause 10 for it.
Gift provision.
You can refer section 56, subsection 2, clause 10 for it.
Yes, sir.
Chala logical. See, if we two happen to be a relative, there is no need to compute capital gains tax, no need to compute gift also. Nee gurtunde.
Yes, sir.
So, case number 6 is very, very important case. Exam mein chaal saal adutaru kuda. Very, very important case. Shall we?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So case number 6 here. Case number 7. This is case number 6, na? Case number 7.
Case number 7.
See, Karthik, if you understand, I am an amalgamating company.
Yes, sir.
You are my shareholder. So what will happen, you know? You will receive shares of amalgamated company when the company goes for amalgamation. Matlab shareholders of amalgamating company, yes, without their acceptance or without their knowledge, they'll get shares of which company? Amalgamated company.
Amalgamating.
Which is logically a barter. Exchange or barter. But still government says, don't treat this as transfer. Why? Because this transfer is happening because of amalgamation. Yeah. Because this transfer is happening because of amalgamation.
Amalgamation. Yes, sir.
Shall we write?
Yes, sir.
If shareholders of amalgamating company. If shareholders of amalgamating company, the whole point is in the hands of shareholders. Jagrata.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Relaxation is in shareholders ki, company ka.
Okay.
The shareholders of amalgamating company receives shares of amalgamated company, then such exchange will not attract capital gains tax. I hope I am very clear.
Yes, sir.
ఎందుకంటే మనం చేయట్లేదు బికాస్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేషన్ దిస్ ఇస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ వి ఆర్ నాట్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ దిస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేషన్ అంతే కదా ఇప్పుడు నా ఇన్వాల్వ్మెంట్ ఏముంది దాంట్లో ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ ఐ డోంట్ లైక్ అమాల్గమేషన్ అండ్ మెనీ అదర్ పీపుల్ లైక్ నో ఆప్షన్ సో ఫర్ అమాల్గమేటింగ్ కంపెనీ షేర్స్ ఐ విల్ రిసీవ్ విచ్ కంపెనీ షేర్స్ అమాల్గమేటెడ్ కంపెనీ షేర్స్ ఇక్కడ నీకు కొన్ని డౌట్స్ వచ్చాయి ఇప్పుడు సార్ అమాల్గమేటెడ్ కంపెనీ షేర్స్ ఫ్యూచర్ అమ్మితే యూ హావ్ టు కంప్యూట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్ నా అర్థమవుతుందా ఐఎమ్ అ షేర్ హోల్డర్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేటింగ్ కంపెనీ లేటర్ ఐ బికమ్ అ షేర్ హోల్డర్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేటెడ్ కంపెనీ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేషన్ ఫ్యూచర్ మే వెన్ ఐ సేల్ ద షేర్స్ ఆఫ్ అమాల్గమేటెడ్ కంపెనీ షుడ్ ఐ కంప్యూట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్ ఆర్ నాట్ అప్పుడు వాట్ ఇస్ ద కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్విజిషన్ ఆఫ్ టెట్ కంపెనీ షేర్స్ ఎంత పెట్టి కొన్నట్టు ఫ్రీగా వచ్చినాయా
old shares by new
shares very good the old cost will continue as new cost yes, very sir. good the old cost will continue as new cost
okay
oh na
yes sir yes sir
likewise case number 8 on conversion of debentures into equity shares obviously of the same company hello
yes sir yes sir
if you are converting debentures into equity shares of the same equity company shares. obviously same company imagine 5 years tarata government matlab the company promise after 5 years for every one debenture will get 5 equity shares okay so ee conversion aithe ayindi but government says no need to compute capital gain when I'll compute capital gain when the shares are sold
equity shares are sold
very good and for that purpose 5 equity shares cost ఎంత అంటే cost of one debenture
yes
5 equity shares cost ఎంత అంటే cost of
one debenture
అంతే కదా నా nothing wrong na
yes sir
అర్థమవుతుందా
yes sir yes sir
next case number 9 8 or 9
9
conversion of preference shares into equity shares wow this is conversion of preference shares into equity shares same if you observe conversion of debentures into preference ledu alane conversion of preference into debentures ledu
yes sir
relaxation is only when you receive upon conversion only equity this relaxation will apply and indirectly cost of old debentures will continue as cost of new equity shares likewise cost of preference
share shares
will continue as cost of equity shares very good nana adhamavutunda
yes sir
case number 10 shall we move
yes sir
in case if the transfer of capital asset is historical item ante telugulo undra na telidu old items or archaeological collections in case of transfer of capital asset is historical items or archaeological collections then there would be no capital gains eppudu telsa if such a transfer is to गवर्नमेंट और गवर्नमेंट लाइब्रेरी और गवर्नमेंट म्यूजियम्स। ओह इफ इमेजिन ना देख रहा ये तो हिस्टोरिकल आइटम होंगी सम 3000 इयर्स ओल्ड गोल्ड कॉइन आई गॉट आ टाइम लो गोल्ड कॉइन अभी दैट गोल्ड कॉइन आई एम ट्रांसफरिंग टू तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट एंड तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग मी 10 लाख रुपीस फॉर दैट सिंगल कॉइन नो नीड टू कंप्यूट कैपिटल गेन
कैपिटल गेन
అంటే ఇండైరెక్ట్లీ మీ దగ్గర ఏమైనా హిస్టారికల్ ఐటమ్స్ కానీ ఆర్కియాలజికల్ కలెక్షన్స్ కానీ ఏమైనా ఉంటే నోట్ యూ హ్యావ్ రైట్ టు మేక్ అ సేల్ టు అవుట్సైడర్స్ బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ మేక్ అ సేల్ టు అవుట్సైడర్స్ యూ హావ్ టు కంప్యూట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్ ట్యాక్స్
క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్
సో గవర్నమెంట్ సేస్ మాకు ఇచ్చేయండి మేము ఇచ్చిన కన్సిడరేషన్ పైన నో నీడ్ టు కంప్యూట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్ ట్యాక్స్
క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్స్
క్లియర్
ఎస్ సార్
బోలో నా సార్
ఎస్ సార్
కేస్ నంబర్ 11 If an individual transfers capital asset under a reverse mortgage scheme, if an individual transfers capital asset under a reverse mortgage scheme, under
reverse mortgage scheme,
Gurtunda Chapanidi. Section 10, subsection 43.
Parents.
Yeah, reverse mortgage scheme. So if you're an individual and if you're making a transfer of capital asset under reverse mortgage scheme, there is no need to compute capital gain. Kani jagratta. Are they property banker amneste?
Then
they have to compute capital gain. There is no relaxation. That's called alienation of property. And you don't have any more right over the property to take back.
Yes, sir.
రివర్స్ మార్టిగేజ్ లో ఒక బెనిఫిట్ ఏంటంటే ఐ గివ్ ద అసెట్ ఐ టేక్ ద మనీ జనగా మనం మనం తీసుకుని అసెట్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తాం ఇక్కడ అసెట్ తీసుకుని మనీ తీసుకుంటున్నాం
మనీ తీసుకుని
బట్ ఫ్యూచర్ లో ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ మై అసెట్ బ్యాక్ ఐ కెన్ పే ద బ్యాంకర్ అండ్ గెట్ ద అసెట్ బ్యాక్ నా అదే అసెట్ బ్యాంకర్ అమ్మేస్తే ఖేల్ ఖతం యూ హావ్ టు కంప్లీట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్ హూ ద బ్యాంకర్
బ్యాంకర్
ఐ మీన్ క్లియర్ సో ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఏంటరా అంటే ఇక్కడ ఇట్ ఈస్ అండర్ రివర్స్ మార్టిగేజ్ స్కీమ్ The assets transfer should be under reverse mortgage scheme. Shall we?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Case number 12, which is an important case. Case number 12, a redemption of gold deposit bonds. Oh, just to transfer, if you observe, I have written a very key word here, redemption.
Redemption.
Redemption ante. You have to wait up to the redemption period. Redemption of gold deposit bonds by an individual. Matlab indirectly this relaxation is given only to individuals.
Individuals.
Neeku starting lo cheppan gurtunte. Mee daggara old gold unte. Old gold kada, old gold. If you got old gold, you can deposit under gold monetization scheme.
Gold monetization scheme.
Neeku oka certificate istaru. That certificate is not a capital asset. So lifelong no need to pay capital gains tax.
Capital gains.
It is different. What I am discussing now is altogether different. This gold is gold bonds. Deposit bonds. Reserve Bank of India issue chestundi RBI.
Yes, sir.
And the gold rate chala perugutundi kadanna. See, COVID low 30,000, gold rate has become 50,000. Very good investment. So I want to purchase gold. Kan gold konte, physical gold konte, government lose foreign currency. So Reserve Bank of India says, Panji, and purchase these bonds. Our guarantee, the bond value is equal to gold value.
Yes, sir.
Bond value, gold value, and indirectly, no need to import gold.
Yes, sir.
Ani, konin tarata, majjilo amme savan ko, you have to compute capital gain. Yappuda mali,
redemption time.
Only redemption time lo. Matlab, if the bond is having a lock-in period of 5 years, this benefit will come only after 5 years.
5 years.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So if you are doing redemption of gold deposit bonds, then relaxation is given to you only at the time of redemption.
For individuals. Yes, sir.
Individual only. You don't have doubt. Careful.
Yes, sir.
Karthik bond nu konnav. 7 years bond.
Yes, sir.
Konin tarvata nu fourth year naku ammesav.
Okay, sir.
That bond I am holding for 3 more years.
Yes, sir.
Will you compute capital gain or not? Will you compute capital gain or not on transfer?
Yes, sir.
Will I compute capital gains after 3 more years?
No, sir.
very good. Ante the person who is going for redemption need not be the original buyer of the bond. Very good. I don't know how you are telling it, but the point is right. Konina vaadu original buyer redemption chesthe isthanam ledu. Any individual who is going for redemption, there is no need to compute capital gain. Ante ee example lo Karthik will compute capital gain, but Ashwin will not compute capital gain. Why Karthik will compute capital gain? Because he is making a transfer before redemption.
Redemption, yes sir.
And Ashwin Gilda is going for redemption. He is waiting for 3 more years. Then he is going for redemption.
Yes sir.
So what we are discussing, if you remember, we were discussing transfer case.
Yes sir, transfer.
Excellent. What is transfer? We started. No need to revise so much. What is important to understand is what is not a transfer. Liquidation case, partition case, holding to subsidiary case, subsidiary to holding
subsidiary
case.
Subsidiary to holding case.
Yeah, very good. Amalgamation case.
Yes, sir.
Gift case.
Yeah.
Shareholder of amalgamating company case.
Yes, sir.
Conversion of debenture into equity shares case.
Conversion of preference shares to equity.
Yeah, conversion of preference shares to equity shares case.
Yes, sir.
Transfer of historical items to government case. Transfer of asset under reverse mortgage case. Case. Last may redemption of gold deposit bonds.
Yes.
These are those cases where the transfer is not treated as transfer.
Not treated as transfer.
So what we'll do, we'll write a small note.
Yes.
Note. Raskochka point.
Yes, sir.
Note number one. Ayo. In all the above cases, there would be no capital gains.
Capital gains.
There will be no capital gains tax in the hands of transferor. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Transferor case, there is no need to compute capital gains.
Capital gains.
Right. However, if transferee makes a further transfer, gurtostunda?
Yes, sir.
Or if transferee makes a further transfer, further ante inka mundu kamistunnadu vadu.
Yes, sir.
Holding ichin subsidiary ki subsidiary amesindi asset ni. Holding to subsidiary, subsidiary has sold. However, if transferee makes a further transfer, then capital gains tax would attract. Avuna?
Yes, sir.
And general ga for this purpose, ee purpose kosam cost of acquisition cheppal kada.
Yes, sir.
For this purpose, the deemed cost of acquisition would be, for this purpose, the deemed cost of acquisition would be cost to the previous owner. Do you agree?
Okay. Yes, sir.
The old asset cost will continue as new asset cost.
Yes, sir.
Our old owner's cost will become new owner's cost.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Owner same ankona na, debenture holders will become equity holder anko. Cost of debenture will continue as cost of equity.
Yes, sir.
Adhe H of asset has become now member asset anko. H of asset has become member asset anko. అప్పుడు ఫర్ మెంబర్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద కాస్ట్ అంటే కాస్ట్ టు హెచ్ఎఫ్
yes sir
డీమ్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్విజిషన్ విల్ బి నథింగ్ బట్ వాట్ సర్ కాస్ట్ టు ది ప్రీవియస్ ఓనర్
yes sir
అదోతనా
yes sir yes sir
ఇఫ్ హెచ్ఎఫ్ హస్ గివెన్ ద అసెట్ టు మెంబర్ అండ్ మెంబర్ హస్ సోల్డ్ ఇట్ సో మెంబర్ చేతిలో వి హావ్ టు కంప్లీట్ క్యాపిటల్ గెయిన్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్విజిషన్ ఎంత అంటే గవర్నమెంట్ సే
బై హెచ్ఎఫ్
యా కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్విజిషన్ టు ది మెంబర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్విజిషన్ టు హెచ్ఎఫ్ ఇదంతా లోలి ఎక్కడ చెప్పాడంటే సెక్షన్ 49 సబ్ సెక్షన్ 1 ఆల్ దిస్ డ్రామా ఇస్ గివెన్ ఇన్ సెక్షన్ 49 సబ్ సెక్షన్ 1
49 సబ్ సెక్షన్ 1 సర్
హరి దో నమస్కారం ఆల్ దిస్ డ్రామా ఇస్ గివెన్ ఇన్ సెక్షన్ 49 సబ్ సెక్షన్ 1
yes sir
ఇంకా ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ నడుస్తుంది. సి ఇఫ్ యూ రిమెంబర్ వాట్ వి హావ్ కవర్డ్ నౌ, వాట్ వి హావ్ కవర్డ్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద టర్మ్ కాల్డ్ క్యాపిటల్ అసెట్. వాట్ వి హావ్ కవర్డ్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద టర్మ్ కాల్డ్ వాట్ యు నో ట్రాన్స్ఫర్. అండ్ ఆల్సో వి హావ్ కవర్డ్ వాట్ యు నో, వి హావ్ కవర్డ్ ఎక్సెప్షన్స్ టు ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఇఫ్ యూ రిమెంబర్.
Section 47.
Yeah, what we have covered is exception to transfer. That is section number 47. Adi kuda cover chesam. So two points we have covered indirectly. What we'll do? We'll take a break. We'll resume back post lunch. We'll understand the meaning of the term called what you know, capital gains. Short term capital gain, long term capital gain. How to compute and how to understand the term of an asset. Okay, said long term eppudu, okay said short term eppudu, that we'll understand.
Okay,
okay nana.
Yes sir.
Chalo, I'll give you a message once we resume back. Okay,
okay sir.
No appudu daaka lunch complete chesedam.
Okay sir,
bye
bye sir.